After years of waiting, Evangelion 3.0 plus 1.0, Thrice Upon a Time, is finally out. It's no secret that I like Evangelion. It was one of my first anime I've ever watched, and because of it, it just has a special place in my heart. I'm not a huge fan of anime, but when it includes giant robots and mindfuckery, of course I'm gonna watch it. Evangelion just has something that makes it unique. Before we begin, I've only just seen the movie recently, because I just wanted to upload this video as early as possible. Also, I won't be including any spoilers, so if you don't want to hear any spoilers, you're completely safe. Although, I will be talking about how I felt about the characters in this movie, so if you don't want to hear anything about that, feel free to skip between this time frame that's on the screen. Anyway, with that out of the way, let's begin. If you're a fan of Evangelion, you'll love this movie. Evangelion 3.0 plus 1.0 is a film made for fans, and it's not much of a surprise since it's the final installment of the reupload movies concluding the franchise. First of all, the scenes were just amazing, and sometimes even breathtaking. A good majority of these are in like the first hour of the movie. They're extremely detailed and just beautiful to watch. I'll admit, some of the backgrounds look like they belong to an art museum. The movie is slow, but in a lot of ways, the first hour of the movie demonstrates what's been missing from the rebuild movies. And there's like a lot of time spent developing the relationships between the characters. However, it's almost non-stop chaos. Or just messing with your mind, which Evangelion is famously known for. It's just very... I don't know how to describe the other half of the movie, but it felt like the craziest movie I've ever seen this year. It's just... maybe even the craziest movie I've ever seen in my entire life. It's just absolute madness. Like, the craziest shit you could imagine. I couldn't even tell you what the hell was going on, but it was beautiful, and it was very fun to watch. Alright, so now that I've actually talked about the movie, let's briefly discuss about the characters and how I felt about them. Shinji is depressed, as always, and I don't blame him, especially after seeing Karu's head explode and almost starting the fourth impact. I thought Rei and Oscar would both help Shinji get back on his feet, but no, instead, all three of them help each other grow and develop, which I was not expecting, and I personally love the dynamic between the characters. As for Misato, also known as Best Girl by the way, if the last movie left you confused and disappointed about her, you'll get to understand her driving motivations in this movie. Karu returns in this movie by the way, and you actually get to see him cry, which I thought was surprising. And without getting into spoiler territory, just know that he does appear in a couple of scenes. So yeah, he's a recurring character in this movie. So overall, I enjoyed Evangelion 3.0 plus 1.0. In a lot of ways, this film does feel like an end of a series. I was expecting this movie to be like somewhat confusing, just like the end of Evangelion. But it didn't really feel like that. It answered most of the questions that I had, and it did wrap up the series on a satisfying note. The only thing that I regret is paying for Amazon Prime. Yeah. So anyways, thank you for watching.